landscape of Call of Duty is changing once again, and this time, back to what we've wanted for 3 years now. Four words, boots on the ground. What's up, guys? Enos here again today, bringing you guys some Infinite Warfare sniping gameplay, and I'm bringing good news. I feel like Santa Claus, I'm bringing cheer and good news. I am here to tell you, just in case you haven't heard yet, that Activision announced yesterday, in conjunction with Sledgehammer and some of their CFOs, CEOs, and other things, that we will be brought a boots on the ground Call of Duty in 2017. Later this year, it is their year to do the 3-year development cycle, and thank God they're finally going back to boots on the ground. You can look up everything on Twitter, keep up with all of it. If you just literally pull up a Call of Duty Twitter page of any sort, whether it be the actual Call of Duty page or an information page, whatever, it'll be there. And they basically said they're going back to the roots of Call of Duty and what made it great. Unfortunately, I'm going to assume that means we're still going to have supply drops, but what it does mean, from what everybody has been assuming, is that we're not going to have to worry about jetpacks anymore. And just to throw this out here, this guy just ate a crap ton of bullets. I hit him with a sniper bullet, a pistol bullet, and then like three more pistol bullets, and he still didn't die. That's besides the point. Anyway, thank God we don't have to worry about jetpacks anymore. The last one we had that didn't have jetpacks was Ghost, and everybody hated it, and everybody was bored with it. And I'll admit, it wasn't the greatest game, but in my mind, it was pretty dang underrated. And I'm stupidly excited to be going back to boots on the ground. And hopefully, it'll be as good as everybody hopes. I'm not going to really mind too much if we have sliding and all that kind of stuff in it. I don't particularly want wall running, but if they want to add in some sliding, just regular sliding, not IW shoot through the freaking wall to the moon type sliding, but like ghost sliding, and maybe even if they wanted to add, you know, something innovative like the peeking around the wall, not peeking around the wall, but something in that general area, you know what I mean? That would be okay with me. But I definitely am excited for boots on the ground. And if they come out like 3 weeks from now and say, you guys all assumed wrong, it's not boots on the ground, I'm probably going to rage quit Call of Duty. I'm not even going to lie. Like, there's a good chance I just won't play Call of Duty ever again. Because I'm going to be honest with you. If it keeps getting worse than Infinite Warfare, I don't think I can take much more. In my mind, the last three games have been absolute garbage. And I'm not saying that Infinite Warfare is worse or better than any of the other ones. I just think all of them have been equally bad. Let's just leave it at that. So I'm definitely looking forward to a boots on the ground game where I can go back to my tactical, I have a faster reaction time than you and I'm smarter than you type gameplay, and not they boosted over my head, oh crap, I can't see him, where'd they go, oh no, I think he's shooting behind me, let me turn around, oh no, he's really the way I was just looking because he boosted again before I ever got turned around, and then he just hit a wall run and ended 50 feet up in the air, and now he's shooting down on my head, now I'm looking up, but he gravity slammed me, and now I'm weak and stunned, and I can't do anything because he landed on my head, and now he's just bouncing around everywhere, and holy crap, I can't keep up, my sensitivity's too low, holy no, I'm dead. I'm so sick of that crap. So I'm excited for boots on the ground. But also in other news that we did not choose to cover on this channel, supply drops are now in, or not supply drops, supply dropped weapons are now in COD 4 Modern Warfare Remastered, whatever you want to call it. Just in case you guys did not know, there were three weapons. I believe a pistol, the 44 mag, an automatic shotgun that starts with a K that I can't remember how to pronounce, and the XM or X something, I don't know, some kind of assault rifle, something LMR, X something LMR, I don't know. Actually, the assault rifle looks a lot like the ACR, and I know a lot of people were very upset about that, including a rogue bludger, which I'm assuming is why he didn't cover it to this point. He was very upset by that, and I can't really blame him. But to be fair, I do think a lot of people have got their hopes up a little too much for this game. You know, everybody was extremely excited when they said only cosmetic. You know, it's supply drops, cool, we can customize crap, and it's only going to be cosmetic. I could have told them right off the bat that wasn't going to stay cosmetic, just like it didn't stay cosmetic in Black Ops 3. So, you know, it is what it is. There's nothing we can do about it. I was not too excited about MWR to start with, so it wasn't exactly heartbreaking for me, but I know a lot of the people in the community were extremely upset about it, and for good reason. I mean, they were just straight up lied to for the second year in a row now. So, I mean, I can't really blame them, you know. But that went in at the same time the weapons went into Black Ops 3, such as, or like the PP and the M16, which I covered before in a previous video. If you don't know what I'm talking about, that's on the channel as well. And check out our videos from yesterday. We did the experiment of commentating each other's gameplay, so check those out. They're both up on the channel. And, boots on the ground. We'll see you next time, guys. Peace out.